Hi, I'm Kadra, and I am the after school coordinator for Jefferson After School through Minneapolis Community Ed. So our student population is primarily students of color, coming from low income families. We have a high percentage of free and reduced lunch. We have new immigrants as well as homeless and highly mobile students. The resources and curriculum that One Yoga and Tools for Peace present are very, very necessary because it will allow us to create access to these resources for the kids that need it. There's also the anxiety that resulted from COVID-19, as well as the physical and the emotional impact of all of that. And all of these require a real intervention that allow our students to heal from these experiences of trauma, where they learn how to regulate, how to understand their emotions, how to create empathy for themselves and for each other.
My name is Carlos. I am a facilitator, a yoga instructor, and a trainer here at Tools for Peace. And just a little bit about what we do. At Tools for Peace, our role is really to create and cultivate like a safe space that children can practice mindfulness in, that they can start to explore compassion and just the importance of having a community. And so that's what we do, that's what we build, and that's what we try to cultivate at Tools for Peace, is this sense of one, this sense of belonging and an acknowledgement that we're not alone in our suffering. And so for that reason, it's essential that we get this program to as many students as possible.
Hey, Chance York here, wellness instructor, educator. Worked with kids in a variety of capacities, teaching literacy, teaching yoga, meditation for different schools and different after school programs. In Tools for Peace, I was very impressed by the totality of it. Has a lot of great exercises, a lot of great concepts, opens up the window for interaction, opens up the creative side of everything, and then the application of it. I definitely believe in its quality, and I know the need is currently very vast. Just teaching kids kindness, compassion, impermanence, the things that there's not a lot of places to learn it.
Hi, my name's Abby Posner, and I'm the musical director and one of the head facilitators at Tools for Peace. Tools for Peace is one of the most important things that I do in my life. I've been a facilitator and a teacher there for over 10 years now. And teaching teens and young people about change, and these kids are taking all the tools that we're giving them and they're bringing it into their schools and their families, and they're spreading so much joy and they're spreading so much mindfulness in the world. So I feel like Tools for Peace is one of the most valuable things that we can offer. It is truly one of the most amazing things that I do with my time. So thank you so much.
My name is Danielle Dickerson. I'm calling in from Los Angeles, California. I'm one of the Tools for Peace facilitators. And for youth, that they're getting the same opportunity to not only, connect with the parts of themselves that are not necessarily accessed outside in their daily lives, but really having the opportunity to connect with others and relate to others in a different way.
Hi everyone, I am Stacey Fonseca. I was a Tools for Peace student back in sixth grade, and now I am a facilitator teaching in middle school. I've stuck through the curriculum for so long just because it's always made me have the curriculum and the keys I need in order to succeed and go through any hardship. Even as a child, when I was going through losses or my parents' divorce, it's always reminded me that change has happened and to be grateful for what I have now. And teaching that to the students is so heart-filling because I know that they have the tools they need to now succeed.
Hi, my name is Saron Manny, and I work for Tools for Peace. I'm a camper turned facilitator. I've been involved since I was 15 years old, and I'm 22 now, and it's just been a wonderful, beautiful, loving journey. I teach it twice a week to middle schoolers, and the experience is just remarkable. I mean, these kids love it. They come back every week, and I see these changes in them as time goes on. They're so excited to tell me about stories, about how they handle the situation differently, or how they calm themselves down when they were feeling anxious. And I think that this needs to be everywhere, and it needs to be taught everywhere, and it needs to be utilized all over the world, wherever it can be, because, I mean, it's a foolproof, no limitation curriculum, and it makes me feel so proud, and I cannot wait to see what else I can do for this wonderful, beautiful family that I am so lucky to have.